Okay, I kind of want to grab remote treatment just because it is a way of dealing with blue.
That it is. It is a way of dealing with blue.
So I've just come off my loading screen now, so we are now broadcasting to the internet.
Hello.
Hello, Internet.
So yeah, we're just setting up ready for our next game. We had two attempts at January. Attempt one ended poorly.
Yeah.
Attempt two went a lot better.
Well, yeah, we almost got a dream run on attempt two.
Yeah, the scientist got a bit fucked up at some point,
That
but
was the first
yeah.
attempt.
So
That was you
it's
getting stuck
fine.
in that situation in South America.
The less we speak about South America, the better.
We don't speak about South America anymore. I'm surprised she doesn't have the PTSD scar instead.
So for anybody who's not, obviously you might be familiar with Ordinary Pandemic, but for anybody who's not played the legacy version, we're now into our second month, which means we now have a disease that cannot be treated or cured.
Which is problematic.
A
Just a
bit
little bit.
problematic.
Yeah. I mean, okay, so the regular pandemic, like if we get rid of the stuff from the board quickly. Regular Pandemic is a game where you try to save the world from disease. There will be four diseases on the board that you have to clear out with the special characters that have special abilities. And like these cards are not in the original game either.
There's some of them are similar with the original game.
Yeah. But what makes this special is the fact that it's a legacy game, which means there are now permanents, in that you add permanent things to the board. Like over here, if you look here, we have added some positive mutations to our diseases that make them easier for us to cure. And we also have, through the game, gotten a very negative mutation on one of them that have made it impossible to cure or treat.
And in the real game, these are stickers that you change the board by putting the stickers on the board.
Yeah, they're not intended to come off.
No.
We've also got some cities here that have effects because they had lots of outbreaks.
Yeah, so what happens is you put a st every time an outbreak happens, you put a sticker here to show that something went bad. And it's basically the city getting more and more panicked as it goes on, and then you later can hit points where the city is just, it's fallen. It's gone. It's gone for the rest of the game.
So yeah, at the moment
Gone, but
we
not
can't
forgotten.
fly directly into a few of these cities anymore, which is a little bit of an
Yeah.
issue.
Yes.
And you can't ever have a research station there again.
So while it's a game you play only play once, legacy games can be seen more as kind of a game of D&D or something like that, where it's an experience you experience once and you just, carry that experience with you. And
Or you
it's
play it on a digital version, and then you can undo everything you've ever done.
Yep.
Doesn't
So
change the
we
story,
have
of
all
course.
of these special doors and flaps over here, and some packages.
Yep. These are new things that will be added to the game as the game goes on. And the thing that controls the entire game is this thing over here. As you can see, this one says draw at the end of your first game in February. That's when we do that, and we will draw that, and new aspects will be added into the game. Usually, you open one of these doors or one of the boxes, and they get added into play in the game. And I read an interview with the guy who made this. He kind of envisioned this as, you know, a weekly TV show serial thing.
Which is why it's called Season 1.
Yeah, so you will have aspects later. Like, there is an actual story going on here. Which we will get to know more and more of.
Yeah, we accidentally saw we had a spoiler because we opened the wrong box.
Yeah, we had a tiny spoiler, but I don't think that's going to be too much of a problem.
So yeah, for stream, if I get this in focus. So when we finished the game in January, we were told to open, from that legacy deck, we were told to flip this card, and this told us to open a whole bunch of different doors, which gave us a couple of cool things. We got a new character, which is the Quarantine Specialist, which is going to be very, very useful when it comes to dealing with our untreatable disease. And we also got relationships.
Yeah, the relationship rule, which is when you create one of these characters, you basically get to name them and stuff. Relationships is a new mechanic, so when you create a character, you also add a relationship to them, like rivals with. So whenever a rival plays or discards a card, you may immediately discard any two cards to pick it up. Basically special abilities that interact between those two characters.
Our favorite one is co-workers with, which basically means that for sharing research, or sharing cards to allow research, they've discovered email. You don't have to both be in the city named on the card.
I just think of the bit that Dara Brian did about 2012, the disaster movie, where he does a whole bit about the intro of that movie because it's super dumb. Because it features, first of all, a scientist traveling to India just so he can hear what this big new thing is. He's like, could you just not have sent me an email? We have that stuff now.
Oh, yes, and as part of the Quarantine Specialist, we now have the ability to place quarantine markers in cities.
Which we will have to do to combat the blue threat of Coda.
Which means that instead of outbreaking, you remove the quarantine marker.
Yeah.
However,
which is explained on this handy sticker.
Quarantine markers placed by the quarantine specialist are never removed.
Yes.
If you're in that city.
If they're in that city. In fact, it doesn't. They don't have to be placed by the quarantine specialist. Also, to place a quarantine marker, if you are not the quarantine specialist, you need to be in that city.
Yeah, and the quarantine specialist can just place it anywhere.
Yep. Once per turn.
Yeah. So, let's get into it. Let's get some characters on the board. Who wants to play the quarantine specialist?
I do.
All right. You get to name the quarantine specialist, and you also get to choose a relationship and with whom. I'm going to go pick up the researcher again.
Yeah.
Well, considering my terrible, terrible luck at drawing cards last game, well, there's probably no chance that's going to happen again, so I'm going to play the scientist again.
Obviously.
There we go.
I think we want the medic over the dispatcher this time.
Maybe? Yeah.
The dispatcher could come in handy with the quarantine specialist, though.
Yeah, but the medic just
might be an idea to bring in the general,
because
so we can
we
take
have all these positive mutations now.
Relationships.
Yeah, that's right. The generalist hasn't been created yet, so we could take the generalist and strap a relationship on it.
I honestly don't think the generalist is that useful yet.
No.
No, like, the medic and dispatcher is just way more useful. But I think the dispatcher is more useful in this case because we have the positive mutations in all the viruses. So the dispatcher, or the dispatcher, is more useful because the we can all just do the same thing as the medic later on.
Yeah, because we can discover cures without needing to go to research stations.
Yeah.
Okay, I will take the dispatcher again then, and we will sideline the medic.
Sorry, Rand medic.
Yeah.
You're not invited. You're not invited to the dispatcher. Now, Quarry.
But Quarry, the quarantine specialist.
Oh yes, you've already got the Ran in there.
I will book a flight to wherever you are and punch you in the face.
Okay, so who do you want a relationship with?
It's a good question.
What relationship and with what character?
Also a good question.
Yeah, Jacob would like.
I think co-workers or rivals are probably the better ones.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would have said co-workers with the researcher.
Yeah, because that lets me pass around cards really quickly. So I would also go with that.
Sure.
Let's see. This co-workers thing is large. Wait, let me resize it.
Yeah. Some of these stickers are a little bit weirdly sized.
How do I resize?
I think only I can do that.
Okay.
There we go. Maybe one smaller. Alright, I am co-workers with Quarry.
Meaning you can just throw cards at Quarry.
Yeah. I mean, as said, like, it's more or less pandemic, but they have rebalanced the game a bit. There's some changes they have done to the game, like how some characters work or...
And some of the city links are slightly different.
Yeah, some of the connections.
Yeah, so Santiago is no longer a dead end.
And, yeah, because they add another, like, balance mechanic, which is these cards, the funded cards, which is what this is all about, this over here. So, the natural balancing mechanic in this is if you lose a game, you get more funding, which lets you pick more of these cards. For each funding you have, you get to pick one more of these cards. If you're doing well, they'll be like, oh, you have this under control. We'll just remove your funding. And all of these funding cards are all of these cards are super powerful abilities that goes straight into player deck, which means, first of all, we'll be drawing less epidemics, hopefully. Because there's more chances to draw these.
Yeah. Last game, Hub drew all our epidemics.
Yeah.
Yeah, which, that was a thing that happened. I drew, like... Yeah, there was, like...
We had two epidemics in a row.
Yes, the same person pulled them both on their turn. It was insane.
Yeah.
Yeah. That game happened.
Which ones did we have again? We had Forecast. Yeah. I guess we want Forecast again. Do you want One Quiet Night?
One Quiet Night was very useful.
Resilient Population, I guess.
Yep.
Yeah. Last time we had Borrowed Time, but Remote Treatment, I think, is a better choice this time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just to deal with blue.
Right.
It's the only way we can remove blue from the board.
Yeah, all right.
Which will quickly become relevant.
We'll take those four as our funded, shuffle them into this deck.
And then everyone takes two cards from it.
I got Osaka.
Dhaka and Johannesburg.
And I have.
I got Atlanta and Mexico
City.
All right, and now let's split this into piles.
Right. I have. Let's have a look. Chicago. Ah. And Miami.
Well, we've got a lot of yellow.
Yeah. Yellow and blue for the most part. Pretty blue is useless.
We can't treat blue, so blue cards are basically our moving around or discarding cards, which is the scar that the scientist took. The scientist was in a city that had an outbreak, so every time we reveal an epidemic card, Hub has to discard a card. So Hub having a stack of blue cards, which are effectively useless right now, is actually pretty good.
Yup.
Right.
Because it gives me something that is just basically filling for my hand that I can just throw out.
Back it up. We're almost ready to play.
Yep. Now we just need to set up the initial infection.
Yep. And now we just basically hope for very little blue.
Yes.
And yeah, but we do have this bonus. From
yeah, we do have the win bonus.
So, speaking of which, we need 3 in London, 3 in Santiago, and 3 in Cairo.
Because of course we do.
So do we just want to remove 1 from London to begin to start with?
Almost certainly. Let's just see what we've got elsewhere. But given that there's no other way of clearing London...
Here it is.
It's either that or Quarry's first move is to basically just quarantine London.
Okay, we need 2 in Washington, Delhi, and Milan.
Oh, God.
That remote treatment is going to be very useful.
No, that's Mumbai, that's not Delhi. My Indian geography is not what it should be.
We're not doing well on the blue.
Yeah, this is not the greatest start in the world.
can someone get that out? Yeah, thanks.
Don't drop things near bags.
And then 1 in Taipei, Miami, and Tehran.
Taipei.
Yes, Jack, we have the remover card from the disease deck. That was one of the 4 we picked for our funded cards.
Okay, so yes, we should use our win bonus to clear 1 from London.
Yeah.
Yep.
And put it back into the bag it goes.
Yep.
So that's our bonus for winning January, is we're allowed to just remove a cube from a city before we start.
Yeah.
This month.
Very useful.
This month only.
Yeah.
Oh, one of the other things is when we finished January, we were allowed to pick some upgrades. So we took a lot of the positive mutations. The final upgrade we took was to place a research station in Istanbul.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that means we can start in Istanbul.
Who wants to start in Istanbul?
It's probably a good place to start, given that it's only 1 hop to Cairo.
Yeah, look, I think just starting in Istanbul is a strong strategy for everyone this turn. Actually, we want someone pretty close to Santiago.
Yeah, I was going to say, I would probably stick around this way and head down towards Santiago.
It would be good if someone were to duck into Washington and quarantine it.
Well, I can do that.
Their first turn.
I could spend my first turn just moving.
All right, we'll put 2 people in Istanbul and 2 people in Atlanta.
Yep.
Seems
but it also gives us a nice cross-continent hopping point as well. You can fly between research stations.
All right, do we just want to randomize the starts?
Yes.
So let's just do this. I rolled a 18.
Uh-huh. Is it just... Oh, roll, there we go.
You can press R or just throw it.
I rolled a 17.
I got a 6. I don't think I'm going first.
I rolled a 1!
Lam, you start first, then.
Does 1 mean you automatically epidemic on first turn?
Probably.
Alright. 4 actions. I'm just gonna go and wipe up Cairo. Seems just good?
Nuke the whole city.
Yeah, I'm just gonna go nuke Cairo.
It's not that important.
There. Go away, Cairo.
What's even in Cairo?
The pyramids?
Pyramids?
Sphinx?
That's all my actions. Draw 2 cards. San Paolo and Epidemic. So, you know that rolling 1 meant Epidemic on first turn?
But at least I didn't draw it.
You monster lamb.
If that's blue, I'm gonna be sad.
Bangkok.
That's alright. We can live with that.
Okay, yeah. Bangkok is here. Boop.
There.
Wait, is it 3 or is it 1? I forget.
It's 3 on top.
And now we do a regular infection phase at the end of Lamb's turn.
Washington!
Washington, Washington.
Home of the Braves or something. Yep.
Cairo!
Oh, that's convenient that we cleaned that up.
You just cleaned there. God damn it, people.
Yeah, so it's a good thing I did clean it up.
Okay, so we go clockwise around the board?
Yep.
Okay, so my turn. I'm gonna go deal with Washington.
Quarantine Washington.
Okay, where are the quarantine? They're in the bag here. And then, I suppose I could head up towards Europe.
You could go to London, or you could head down towards Santiago. You could go to Miami and clear a cube from Miami.
I mean, Miami is already unstable, so keeping it clear could be very useful.
The thing is I don't want to end my turn in Santiago, particularly now we've had an epidemic, so for me, clearing Miami on the way down would be a good use of my turns.
Fair enough. I think I will actually put down a quarantine in Santiago.
Really?
In my turn. I mean, I'm also going to quarantine Milan, don't get me wrong. But
I guess that does stop outbreaks.
It does.
Happening.
And it's not like they get permanently used up.
Yeah. So, do I go yellow or blue? That's the question.
You could go orange.
Thing is, though, we just put Bangkok back on top, and Bangkok is about to outbreak, so maybe one of on Keeb's turn, maybe he wants to throw someone to, I mean, where can you throw someone in the red area? You can't.
I can't.
Keeb, you could fly to Mexico City, by the way.
I can, yes.
Oh,
yeah,
also
that would let me take a cube off, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, fly to Mexico City for 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, I'll do that then.
Sorry, so actually, I misread that. You could fly to Santiago by going to Chicago and then discarding Chicago and flying to Santiago.
Ooh, yes, that's even better.
Yeah, you could take two cards off.
Two cubes off.
Yeah, two. Cards.
I'll move to Miami and clear that then.
Alright.
Merp. And now,
I guess on my turn I will fly to Osaka and keep red clear.
Oh right, I was epidemic. I was supposed to have discarded. I forget.
Yeah. You were.
I don't actually have Paris.
Oh, yeah. So let's look at Hub for a quick second for everyone watching. Hub's character, the scientist, has a scar because she was caught in a bad situation, and now she's permanently scarred. And the scar she has means she's demoralized. Every time we reveal an epidemic, he has to discard a card.
Yeah, because she was just so traumatized by the shit that went down in our first game in January.
And a character can only have two scars. Once they need to get a third scar, that's it. That character is dead.
Dead forever.
You are meant to literally tear up the character card.
Yep.
Okay.
I think that's actually what's beautiful about this game. Because the whole permanence aspect, I just really like that aspect. It makes things like you having to actually tear up a character if they die more powerful.
And that's my turn.
I mean, I know people already that are planning to frame parts of this game. Because the game just had that much of a powerful effect on them.
I'm curious as to how long it will be until someone produces a competitor. Like, because all of the legacy games are by the same company.
Same game designer. Because he's doing a new legacy game, which is by Hasbro.
Okay, that's interesting. I wonder when the first person to actually copy it will be.
Yeah, me as well, because Legacy is really... It's just a really interesting mechanic to add to it. Like, in another interview, he talked about how basically he's very inspired by video games with the whole
thing. Keab, good job.
And the idea is kind of like introduce... So that basically the idea is to introduce mechanics and in the same fashion as video games do, kind of like piece by piece.
Okay, and you've drawn your card, so it's my go.
Yep.
Okay. So move here, quarantine.
You didn't actually have to move there to quarantine.
I know, but...
He can now remote quarantine Bangkok.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So I think I will then move to London, but remote quarantine Bangkok.
And then remove...
Well, actually, yeah, no, that's a good choice.
And then quarantine London?
I can't. I've used four moves.
Oh, yeah.
In fact, wait, 1, 2, 3, I'm in Essen. Not London when I did that. Because it's still an action to do the remote quarantine.
Yeah.
Okay, now. Let's see what we get.
Pandemic? Or, I mean, epidemic.
Hopefully not.
Okay.
I see you have some yellow cards. You should email those to me sometime.
Hey, look. Bangkok just popped up.
Which means its quarantine goes away.
As did Miami.
We have saved Bangkok from disaster.
How was maths, honey?
Boop.
Okay.
Here we go. And now it is Lamb's go.
Awesome.
All right. I'm going to fly to Osaka.
Yeah.
I hear it's nice to come here.
Or am I?
Yeah. Fair enough.
Yeah, I'm going to fly to Osaka.
I normally would have spent more time in the other rooms, but I was doing things. Sometimes I would have spent more time in other rooms. Well, fine then.
Since I have two more actions left to make this move, I'm just going to clean up Taipei and start heading towards Bangkok.
Yeah, seems good.
Right. Card draw. Baghdad and epidemic. No, Beijing.
Okay.
Means we're getting dangerously close to epidemic time.
So remember, as soon as you enter a city with which you have a card for, Lam, you can pass me those other two yellow cards.
Okay, Delhi now has three cubes on it.
Can I just pass however?
Yeah, the researcher can just give them to you whenever.
Yeah.
Oh, right, yeah. So you could... It just takes two actions to do it.
London.
Oh, good.
So we want to quarantine London.
Yeah.
Yeah. And probably hang around London a fair bit.
I could go to London in my turn.
Sure,
it's my turn now, so I could go to London and just quarantine it.
Yeah, that would be a four.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that.
Okay.
Can not worry about London for a while.
Yeah, sure.
Quarantine.
So we still have Delhi and Bangkok as our threatening ones right now. Yeah. Although Delhi's more threatening than Bangkok.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was going to say, on my turn, I could discard Chennai, move to Delhi and take two off, but that would leave two on Santiago.
I think that's fine. That would be probably fine.
Yep. So we'll let Hub draw the epidemic first.
Yep.
Naturally. And then I discard Montreal, because... Yep.
And you do get to draw a second card still, but...
Yeah, but the epidemic resolves first.
Yep. Just epidemic card. And that's... Kolkata!
Oh, good.
Yeah, that's exactly that's what the city we really... Maybe my plan is then to go to Chennai and then clear Kolkata. So there's an outbreak to both of those.
Yeah.
We need both of those cleared.
We still have this step. We're gonna go this, then this goes on top.
And then you draw your other card, which is Montreal. Oh no, you dropped Montreal.
Which is...
Okay. Remote do that now.
Remote treatment. Okay, so
throw that out. Three do we need to remove? Delhi, Kolkata. So
Tehran's also got three on. No, it's only got two.
I can remove two cubes.
One
from Delhi, one from Kolkata. No, one from Kolkata and Bangkok.
Delhi, one from Bangkok, and then I'll take two out of Kolkata on my turn.
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. Because that sounds
middle
good.
One is the most dangerous to.
Okay, so remote treatment goes where then? Then I played it. Does it go?
It goes into the player. I guess no. Yes, put it over to funded.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's not actually meant to go into the player discard, at least in the regular pandemic, because there's ways of drawing from that.
Yeah.
Okay, and now infect step. Cairo.
Cairo.
Hello, Cairo.
Cairo is two again. Washington.
So Washington is no longer quarantined. Okay, and that's my turn.
Okay, so I will discard Chennai. And...
So hopefully we won't go into another or hit another epidemic soon. So
yeah,
Washington should be fine until Ranico's turn.
It should be fine. If we are that unlucky, then we're that unlucky, and we have to deal with that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's only Washington. Who really cares?
Yeah. It'll be fine. We've dealt with this outbreak.
It's
not like it's important. Right, so. Mumbai. Kinshasa. What? That's a little annoying because if I hadn't had to do that, I would then have three black cards.
Yeah, but you have two yellow cards, and I have two yellow cards, and we're right next to each other.
Ooh, yes.
So, we should get those. Wait, can you give me cards? What's the give thing again?
I can only take from you.
Yeah. Lam can only give, And we can only take.
Because otherwise you could give me your cards, and then I could email them to Ranico, and then we'd be able to cure your
You would then have four anyway, so...
Yeah, but
we need five.
Oh, we still just don't
need to go to a research station.
That's right.
Hub is the one that needs four.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's not going well for me so far.
Yeah. Well, let's infect first. Delhi.
Delhi.
Oh dear.
That's not the worst.
Wisely.
Bangkok.
Good thing.
Yeah.
I'm so happy we got that funded event.
Yes.
Yeah. If we didn't, that would have been really, really bad.
Okay, I'm gonna keep playing this board game.
I suspect it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, so my turn. I am going to over to London. Who is in London? It's Hub.
I am here.
I can't really hand over cards. But I'm then going to say, hey, Washington, get more quarantined. Stop not being quarantined.
So now if London appears, it won't actually trigger.
Yep.
Exactly. And then I have two more actions. So so one of the things I could have done actually would have been to drop a quarantine here or in Paris, just so we're covering those cities, but I don't think that's actually very useful.
Not yet.
I mean, it still uses up a thing, but yeah. In theory, I meant to grab the oldest first.
We only have 12 quarantine markers in total.
Yeah. So I think I'm basically gonna sit here and do nothing. I kind of wish I had a better plan. I can go back to Milan, but, yeah. All right. That's it. Unless I can take from Lam. Can I take from Lam?
I was just going to check the wording on that.
Yes. I can.
Okay,
so
then I'm going to take both of Lam's yellow cards.
Perfect.
So that's... All right,
that's my turn. So let's see what we get.
Remember that... what's the hand limit again?
Yes.
The hand limit is 7,
it's
so...
4.
So yeah, just... it's discard time. So discard those
I'm
going to
discard Washington. So all I need is Lam to discover one more yellow card.
Yep.
Yep. And then we can cure Pax Flu.
Yep. So you got
London,
Sao Paulo and
nothing
Buenos
happened,
Aires,
and Santiago. Cube on Santiago.
Santiago is now on 3.
Yep. And I was in the right city.
Yep. London does nothing.
Yep.
Okay, Lamb, it is your go.
Oh dear. Well, Bangkok, we need to fix that. So 1, 2, clear 2.
Yep. I think that's the best we can hope for there.
And then just hope Delhi does not trigger in any way.
Well, until Keab gets to go.
Yeah.
Bangkok.
Thank you for the host, can't wear hats.
Tehran. Hey!
Ooh.
Host times. Welcome to Pandemical Legacy, everybody. I will say right now, to everyone watching that just came in, if you have any interest in playing this game yourself, there is actual possibility of spoilers right now. But since we will basically be only playing 1 month, it shouldn't be that bad.
Yeah.
So if you want to just stick around and get a feel for the game, then it should be cool.
That's why we're streaming this one, because it's early enough into the game that you won't get too many spoilers.
Alright, flip it over, Taipei.
We can live with that.
and Milan. So Milan drops the quarantine.
Also can live with that.
Hmm.
And did someone put one on Taipei? Nope. Done.
I'm almost tempted to pull Lam to Kolkata and steal his two black cards.
Yeah.
Because that would give me four black. Or I can move to Bangkok, it depends. Or do we need to just clear Delhi?
Take one from Delhi if
take
you can.
Take one from Delhi, move me, steal my cards.
So move him, steal a card. Because you can't steal two cards. Yeah.
It's okay, but first it's my turn, yes?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so quarantining Milan, maybe?
Yeah, quarantining Milan sounds good.
That seems...
the other thing would be to try and get to Santiago, which you can't do. You could get to Kolkata, but you couldn't get to Santiago.
He does have a mix...
He can't fly to Mexico City. He's not allowed.
Oh, yeah.
The riots.
Right.
Yeah. So yeah, I could walk to Santiago, but then I'd end my turn in Santiago without clearing it.
That would be a very bad idea, seeing what happened to you last time.
Yeah, that would be very bad. So
I could fly to Miami or Kinshasa, which is going to make me end my turn in Santiago. So
I might just remote quarantine Santiago on my turn.
Yeah.
And then we just deal with Delhi.
It's already been round in this past, so as long as we don't get another epidemic, we should be okay.
Don't say things like that.
It's fine, it's Hub's turn. We won't get an epidemic on Hub's turn.
we probably will.
Oh, is this an epidemic?
On to... quarantine Milan, and... then move.
You could move to Istanbul, which will let you take a direct flight to Atlanta if you need to next turn.
Yeah, that seems sensible. Just in case things start going real pear-shaped.
It'd be good to get a quarantine center in Asia somewhere, by the way.
Yeah,
if anyone happens to have a card spare.
Hong Kong, possibly, as a good central location.
Yeah,
but I don't think anyone has Hong Kong. Okay, I'll draw my cards.
Wait, do we have to have the card?
Yes,
you have to have the card, go to that city, discard the card to create the center.
Okay.
Would you look at that? I drew Hong Kong.
We also have four red cards on the hands right now, so...
Mm. Yeah, so if you were to get to Hong Kong or Bangkok... Lam could pass you some cards.
And then we could, not worry about red.
Yeah, we could cure the red menace.
Kolkata.
I'm so happy we're keeping that clear.
He's over here, and then...
Wrong. Oh, no.
It's on three.
It's on three now, yeah.
So instead of grabbing stuff from Lam, am I just going to take a cube from each?
Yes, I think that's a better choice.
Please do.
My turn's over.
Okay. So we'll move to Delhi. Clear a cube from Delhi.
If this were a regular game of Pandemic, I would be like, you should teleport Lam to... a hub, or vice versa, but it isn't.
It's because we're so afraid of outbreaks now. In a regular game, you're like, outbreaks, we can go to five or six outbreaks, it'll be fine.
Also, we don't want to be in a city where an outbreak's likely to occur.
Yeah, like, the stakes are so much higher in this version of Pandemic.
No, I might draw some more black cards anyway.
Shanghai?
San Francisco. Okay, could be better.
It also makes the drawing of the cards way more tense.
Yeah.
Because you just don't want that epidemic to hit.
Yeah, and there's so many more of them.
Yeah.
And Lam failed in his job of drawing yellow cards. I'm disappointed.
Miami. Montreal. So we're into new cards now.
Okay, that's fun.
Alrighty. My turn.
At least all the...
So...
All the big troubles are
remote quarantine. Poop. And that reminder goes away.
Okay. Santiago's out of mind.
Then I need more actions. I could go and quarantine Montreal. Doesn't seem that useful. But I could do that. I could wander somewhere else. Yeah, so I need one more yellow
hub
card.
Hub only needs four cards, but you can't pass the hub easily.
Yep.
Yeah, I'd have to get to Lamb and take some of his.
Yeah.
So I've got three actions left. I am kind of tempted to just move and quarantine a new city.
I think it's a good idea to keep the quarantines up on blue once they start getting cubes.
The stream is frozen, by the way.
Oh, awesome.
And I'm going to stick on the London quarantine. And that's my turn. So, Seoul?
No, epidemic.
And thank New you. York.
Let me just get rid of my cat, because all he wants to do is climb on me and eat my headphone. Be entertaining if I actually get a proper decent mic like a Blue Yeti, because he'll just start headbutting and purring into that.
Wow.
Right. Thank you.
I've just dropped the stream's bitrate slightly. If that doesn't fix it, I may have to cycle the stream, because it's probably... because the encoding's overloaded a bit. I'm taxing my machine.
Okay, Baghdad and Madrid.
Not the worst again.
Well.
And thanks, Antitonic, for the host as well. And hey, Nav. Sorry, I was fiddling with stream settings, didn't see you come in. Do let us know if the stream actually starts doing stuff again, or not, and I'll cycle it appropriately.
Nope, it's still frozen.
Awesome. And Jacobo says I'm a monster. Alright, let me just cycle the stream.
That was Radical's turn?
Indeed.
Okay. So...
It's time for Lamb to mow.
So you discarded Atlanta to keep Seoul.
Yeah, I discarded my blue cards because they're blue and therefore pointless.
Yep.
I can either get cards to Ranico.
Or you could come find me and give me cards.
He's got four yellow. If you were to give him any black, he would have to discard.
He discards at his next draw, though.
So, the interesting thing to do here would be to build a research center in Bangkok, fly to, I guess, pass hub the one orange card, because that's the cost of doing that.
I mean, it could be giving him the black cards, otherwise.
Yeah, otherwise you could pass him the black cards, and that would put him close.
Let's discard Bangkok to fly to Istanbul.
Yeah, but also... I think if you're going to do that, I'd rather have the research center in Bangkok.
But you could also discard Baghdad to fly directly to Baghdad, which is right... Next
true.
To Istanbul.
Go to Baghdad and then still read, yeah, okay, I think that's worthwhile trade-off.
I just noticed the reason the stream's frozen is OBS is currently reporting an upload speed of 0 kilobytes a second.
Huh.
Fun
times.
I've just switched Ingest server, but I suspect it may be my internet provider. Yeah.
All right, so
it's not uploading anything. It's not actually streaming. That's entertaining.
So Hubcam, Kieran, his turn.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But you still have to draw and infect and do fun things.
This is going to be an epidemic.
Make hub discard. Nope.
This
hey,
is
though. That's good.
There we go.
I will discard Kolkata.
That seems reasonable.
Got two more black cards.
That actually not a
bad
idea.
Yeah, because you can take those black
cards.
Sydney.
You monster. Ah! Wrong one.
That's not supposed to go in Sydney. And shuffle it up. On top. Draw second one.
No, your epidemic was the second card.
Oh,
yeah,
right.
Stop cheating.
Did we up the infection?
Nope, we have not intensified. So draw three cards, Lamb.
Yep. Montreal.
Which
again.
Is not quarantined.
Nope.
It's not too bad, though. That's only two.
Sydney outbreak.
You monster.
Oh, dear. So, goes to Jakarta and Los Angeles. And
I'm in Manila. And Sydney is now unstable.
Well, we knew that.
Could be worse. You still need to
I'm quarantining
one.
Sydney.
You still need to infect one lamb.
Bangkok.
Everything
good thing we're carrying red this turn.
Yes.
Very good. Okay, my turn. I will take two from lamb and I'll also cure red. Wipe. That means I have spent three actions, so I still have one action.
Correct. Which you will use to dance.
Yeah, do I? I could dance over to Atlanta.
Could head down to Cairo.
Yeah.
But then we just end his turn in Cairo.
Cairo's only got two.
Yeah, but he would still end his turn there. I think.
Yes.
I think we need someone.
Wherever
else.
He moves, he will end his turn.
Yes, I'm thinking that as well because there's no one in America right now, so I could hop over to Atlanta and just, you know, start cleaning Miami. Maybe go down Santiago.
Yeah. Fair enough.
Yeah, I will move to Atlanta. Chill out over there. Okay, draw two. Madrid, hello. And London, hello. Well, that wasn't the greatest. Madrid.
Hey.
Which is then two.
Yeah, that's fine.
We're going to need more of those quarantines.
Baghdad. Yeah, I mean, that's easy. I just need to actually have it be my turn. But I'm going to quarantine Sydney.
And Santiago. Which
that's
means
fine.
It's no longer quarantined.
Yeah, that's why we need someone to go handle Santiago.
I can do that. That's next what time. You said. My turn. And that is the end of my turn.
Right.
Okay, so my turn. What's our priority right now? I don't think any of us can easily reach Santiago properly.
I could Sydney?
I could head in towards Red. I could actually discard Shanghai. Does that jump? No, that doesn't jump me any closer.
Where are you, Keeb?
I'm in Tehran at the moment. Actually, yeah, you're Shanghai would move me slightly Tehran. Closer. It's 1, 2, 3. I could end my turn in Sydney, but that's going to be a bad idea.
And your turn in
I could clear Bangkok. I could get to Bangkok.
Yeah,
and clear it.
Good. Would be good if we could get edge areas, a research station in one of these, the border between black and red.
Yeah.
The other thing is, I could move somebody else because I am the dispatcher.
Well.
Move me to. You can move me anywhere, right?
Anywhere with someone else, or just move you. Yeah, you as he would move player. Himself.
Move me to America.
Yeah, you want to go to Atlanta?
In fact, put me.
Because I won one to Atlanta. Because you're on the Istanbul, so you get the free.
Yeah.
I could then put you
in. And
Miami.
Hubs in Atlanta, anyway. So. It's two actions to do that.
Yeah.
Oh.
It's either that or I could move Ranico.
You're stuttering a lot now, so I think you need to reboot your header or something.
Yeah, I think I'm going to need to reset my router or something. I think my internet provider is screwing up quite badly. I've abandoned trying to stream. I've just got no upload speed. But I am still recording locally, so.
Yeah. Yeah, you're stuttering a lot as well.
Had this problem on Saturday with the Firefly stream. Nobody could hear me. I was stuttering very badly.
Yep. What's happening right now?
Maybe you should bounce your connection.
Yeah. Some thunderstorms earlier today. That might be what's causing it. Bear with me a second while I access my router settings. Temporarily offline. Oh. No, I can't do it remotely. Right, let me go press the button on the router. Be back in a moment.
Alright.
Oh.
Hello.
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 And he lives.
I'm alive.
Maybe a little bit.
Problem fixed.
Am I still just as bad? Well, I power cycled the router, so if that hasn't fixed it, then it's not a problem much with more my you can
do. Yeah.
So rejoins the game.
Yep. We just fire up a speed test in the background and see what it looks like. Yeah, you can't even load the speed test.
Oh, that's a telecom. Problem.
Should go with Telia.
Yeah, no, the speed test has got to loading 100% and failed.
Long enough.
Let's put that back on the game. I won't attempt to restart the stream. I think I'll just leave as is. Ooh, yeah, that loading is painfully slow.
I'm trying to resist.
On purposes.
Yeah, I'm still just waiting for the last few bits to load in. That's how slow this is working now. Hey, there we go. I'm back.
There may have been an incident.
Was there an epidemic drawn?
Yes.
Yeah.
A few. Yeah, definitely. Yeah,
we actually drew three in a row.
Yeah, that happens.
Yeah, you'll be fine though.
Yeah. So are we still on my turn?
Yes.
So what did we think was the best course of action then?
I don't think that's gonna work. There you go. Watch out when you drop those.
Just drop them all in the bag. Get in the bag.
Yep.
Oh, there's still one left.
Oh, whoops.
Did you drop me in the bag?
I may have. Yes.
Just get in the bag.
I accidentally dropped you in the wrong bag for added bonusness.
Alright.
So, yeah, we didn't decide on a good course of action for you. You were contemplating driving someone around like a puppet.
Yeah, possibly Lamb. Either that, or yeah. I just start heading towards Bangkok and clearing cubes as I go.
Yeah.
Either clear cubes or just clear Bangkok completely.
I think you should clear cubes from Tehran and Delhi and go to Kolkata.
Yep. I think because they're going to be in this deck ready to go again, aren't they?
Correct. And there aren't any three cube cities in the stack right now.
No. I mean, there's Sydney, but we need to draw another epidemic to trigger Sydney again. What about Santiago? Oh, no, that's just gone, hasn't it? So that's fine.
Yeah, so now that's being quarantined. No, I guess Sydney's being quarantined.
Yeah, Sydney's being quarantined. You guys never were getting any choice about that.
Yeah. Yeah, I think clear two black cubes and get to Kolkata would be fine then. And then end my turn in Kolkata.
And epidemic? Nope.
It's going to happen. We're starting to run low on player cards.
Yeah, no, it has to happen soon. Okay, and you need to discard at least one card. One card, in fact.
What happens when you run out of player cards again?
You lose.
Yeah.
That is, in fact, the way I have lost most often this game.
Uh-huh.
I think I will discard St. Petersburg, because I think Essen could be useful as a quick transit point. Or to mm-hmm. transport somebody from Essen.
Yeah, that sounds reasonable. Okay, now let's infect some cities.
Yay. I don't like that the rules, extra rule space is inside infections.
Pop goes to quarantine.
That's fine. That's what it was there for. Cairo,
yep, that's
not the fine. Worst.
Ish. It's over to the left, yep. And
Cairo
one more.
Is on three now, though.
Oh, we're on three, yes, because we outbreaked again. Outbroke. Delhi.
Delhi.
Hey, we picked the right city to clear.
Okay, my turn. Lam has again failed to draw more yellow. So, Sydney gets quarantined.
I think we need to start putting even more effort into actually curing now, because so close to yellow.
I'd love to. I'm not discarding yellow cards.
And Hub needs to get one more card.
Yeah, to get one more cure black. So, Lam, you better draw black.
Okay,
well, then,
so that's
I also need to get to
that's
you.
Four. And so that's my turn. And Sydney.
Oh.
And resilient population.
That's going to come in handy.
Very useful.
Okay, so now discard down to seven.
Okay, I'm going to discard Sydney.
Yeah.
Just like that.
Red is useless now.
Well,
they're not in good spots is really the problem.
Yeah.
Okay, so that is, now it's infection time.
Yep.
Tehran? Yep, we chose right again. Taipei? And Kolkata?
That's fine, I'll clear that out next turn. Or clear at least one off of it. Maybe two.
Okay, did anyone put on...
As soon as someone draws epidemic, we will resilient population one of these cities.
Yeah.
Did anyone put one on Taipei?
No. Yes. No.
Okay, I'll put one there.
Yeah, because Taipei should be two now.
All right. Done.
Okay, Lam. Your go.
Lam is going to epidemic, I guess.
Clear Cairo?
No, Lam will be clear. It will be Hub.
Yeah, take at least one from Cairo.
Take one from Cairo. What then?
Okay. Yeah, you've got no cards to give anybody.
No, I'm out of cards because I gave everything away.
If
you draw the black we need on my turn,
Baghdad,
I will just move you to hub.
Okay, I'll take one from Baghdad.
Yeah. If you end your turn in Istanbul, I can go there and take a black card from you if you draw it.
Yeah.
So put one back on Baghdad.
Yeah. Then take an extra one from Cairo and end in Istanbul.
Yeah.
And then we hope to God
now,
you will draw
let's,
black.
Let's see what the epidemic is. Ho Chi Minh wouldn't be a bad spot.
There we go.
And there we go.
I'm going to have that from you.
Okay. In fact.
London. Quarantine goes away.
Okay. London pops.
Which means... by the way, we're going to get an epidemic on Hub's turn.
Yeah,
it's just going to happen.
Washington.
Oh,
the epidemic goes away.
Uh-oh.
Next.
Miami.
Hits three.
Oh, this
it's
is
okay,
bad.
Because if Washington pops, it doesn't impact anything else. There's not going to be a chain in blue.
Well,
okay.
It'll put a cube on Miami.
But it doesn't actually affect Miami. It's got to be four cubes of the same color.
How close are we to curing yellow? We're pretty close to curing
Very
yellow.
Very close. Yeah.
And I'm curing black
yellow.
Now. And
Which
I'm,
means
I'm
I can
curing black
clear
now.
Kolkata and Bangkok.
Yeah.
Okay, I move to Istanbul, one action, take a card from Lamb, two actions, cure black, three actions. I still have one more action. What do?
Back to Atlanta?
Yeah.
Probably, yeah. Being in North America seems good.
you had to quickly pop over to Istanbul, cure a disease, and then back again in the same day.
Yeah, and now...
Oh,
nice.
Okay.
That next. Might be worth using.
Epidemic?
Yeah, we'll see.
No. Oh, what? How?
It has to be hub.
Yeah.
There are
literally,
two epidemics.
There's only 13
these...
cards left here.
Yeah, but there's one epidemic in the last 10 or 11 cards. And so it has to be the next two.
Yeah.
It has to be in... the next two. It's possible we'll get two in a row, in which case that forecast will happen.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's resilient population.
Okay, so...
Mm-hmm. Okay,
shall
so
we
then
infect?
I...
Yep. Sao Paulo, we're in new cards.
Yeah, that helps, actually.
That's fine. Cartoon.
Yeah, we just need to
Shanghai.
But red is cured, so...
Yeah, the problem is we just need to get a yellow card, and we will need to... Like, if someone pulls me to Miami,
yeah.
Like, one thing that we could do in your turn is get me to Miami so you can give me Miami. And then we're done. Then the secondary objective is actually get someone to... put down a research center so we can use the end of year, end of month upgrade to keep
it there.
I think,
given how close we are to an epidemic, on my turn, I can move the hub, move myself to Miami, that's two, move you to me, that's three.
And take a cube from Miami.
And just give you yellow.
Okay, I'm only
we
comfortable
risk
with
both
that
taking
if we
a scar.
Remove, if we remove Miami with resilient population, that's fine.
And then you can start your turn, cure yellow, and we're finished. February's 1.
Yeah.
Yeah, I say we windmill slam that.
We gamble, we do the gamble.
Well,
it's not a gamble.
Brazilian population, Miami, it's gone.
Okay.
We don't have to worry about Miami. And then do the thing.
Yeah, let's do the thing.
So, I move myself to Hub. Into Miami. Ranico, come visit Miami.
Sure, I hear the beaches are fine. It's a little bit shaky, a city to go to these days.
Oh, no direct flights in. No, if that's only unstable. That's
it's
fine.
It's not rioting. Yeah.
It's only unstable. Give you Miami.
Got it.
Now bad things happen.
Oh, epidemic.
Yeah, this has to happen. Almost has to. I'm not sure. Let's see once we've done this.
We just locked down so hard.
We should forecast just so we see what's coming up now. Why not?
For shits and giggles, let's see what's coming up.
Right? So we can literally avoid any outbreaks this way.
Yeah.
Manila, Ho Chi Minh, Jakarta, not that we could get any. Because
it's all new cards. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you could do Essen as one of them, yeah.
It was basically all red as well.
Yeah, which don't matter, so.
Cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
And now we know.
And knowing is half the battle.
The other half is infectious diseases.
So, do we bother infecting, or do we just...
Let's play it out, just... I don't know. I feel like we should.
We don't even play a second February.
Yeah, I mean, we get fewer chances to upgrade the board that way, but... We also have fewer outbreaks, so...
Essen's quarantined. Fun time.
Oh, no, that's only if it outbreaks. Not in
No, quarantine is as soon as it should get a cube, it breaks quarantine.
Right. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. When is instructed to add any amount of disease markers to the city of any color, remove the quarantine marker instead of adding disease markers.
Okay. Your turn then, Ranica.
Okay. Well,
one goes on.
Do you know me? I'm going to quarantine Sydney again, and
I think you can double quarantine.
Remove two of these and then cure. Because why not?
Got to use all your actions.
Yeah. Actually, now I think about it, where's Riyadh? What am I going to do instead of all that? Fly one? No, never mind. All right, and now going
to. We already have one in Istanbul, so.
Yeah, but Delhi would be not a bad place to have one.
Yeah.
All right, cured, and we're done.
Yeah, and then. Do we draw the legacy then, or?
Yeah. Draw it at the end of your first game in Feb. So.
We did. Let's scratch it.
Oh, we start with a free quarantine.
That's going to be useful.
Also, yeah. this thing gets destroyed.
Yep.
Yeah, the previous VIN bonus goes away.
Bye-bye.
And then we draw things.
Ooh.
Local initiative and a new assignment to change your character.
That's pretty cool. Particularly if somebody gets scarred. We suddenly find we need a medic.
Yeah, so those are new funded events, so they go in the funded events deck. Okay, and now we clear up the board and...
Yep, and then we'll find out what the next bit is when we set up for the next game.
Yeah. Fun times.
Oh, wait. There it is!
Where was it?
It's the next one. It was the next card.
It was the last possible card in that pack.
Oh, is it? Right, there it is.
It was almost at the bottom.
One Quiet Night was at the very bottom.
One Quiet Night was the bottom card.
Does our funding go down now as we won?
Yes.
We'll only have two funding for the next one.
This is, as I said, a natural balancing mechanic. There's too many cards in this pile.
We got one more epidemic in there. Yeah, there it is.
Where the character markers go?
Why did it change state? Go away.
We can just pop everybody back to Atlanta for now.
There's another epidemic. There's this. There we go.
So we did that with only one outbreak.
Yeah.
Yeah, we smashed that.
Which
means the game is going to add more mechanics now to fuck us over.
Yeah.
Of course.
Well, I mean, one of the interesting things is not having to cure one of the diseases does make it an easier game.
Yes.
Okay, but now we do end of February upgrades.
Yes.
Yes.
So we can't keep a research station because we didn't build any new ones.
Yeah. So we can drop the requirements to cure one or two diseases.
Yep.
No, we don't. We can make it so it doesn't actually take an action to cure one or two diseases. So as soon as you got the cards, it is cured.
Sure, we don't want to start going for like character upgrades.
Character upgrades is something I was thinking.
Yeah.
I mean, if we get like something like Grizzled, we can actually start doing more gung-ho moves.
Mm. Pilot for the Dispatcher would be very good.
Yes, it would be.
Yeah.
Well,
Forecaster.
We can also start getting efficient to sequence.
Yeah.
Maybe we get one efficient to sequence and then we get, say, pilot for the Dispatcher.
Yeah, we can also get an unfunded event.
Mm. Yeah.
So remove a deceased per cube from anyone on the board. Look at as many infection cards as the current infection rate. Or you can discard to remove one cube of colours. Yeah. I think at some point we want to get Forecaster on one of the characters. The start of your turn, Look at the top two infection cards.
I would say let's get Forecaster now.
Yeah, I could go with that.
Let's get Forecaster and Pilot on two characters. Let's do that as our upgrade.
Which two?
Forecaster and Pilot.
Who gets Forecaster?
Yeah, no, on Hub? Which two characters?
Do we give Hub Forecaster?
Here's the scientist. Where did my relationship go?
Keep in mind that Epidemic actually renders your Forecast useless. Because the Forecast is done at the start of your turn.
Yes.
Yeah, so here are the upgrades.
So, you know, it's not a great move to put it on Hub.
True.
Yeah, I'm thinking Pilot just definitely goes on the Dispatcher, though.
Yes.
Yeah.
Put it on Dispatcher. So, Forecaster on Researcher then, because I'm before Hub.
I love how we just assume it's always going to be Hub that draws the epidemics.
Yes.
It basically is.
So I'm going to put that. Upgrade on the researcher. Also makes sense with the flavor.
So the fun thing to note, according to this board, is next month we will have two objectives.
Oh.
Oh, yes.
Great.
Amazing.
As I said, just when we just smashed this, the game is going to fuck it up again. So, let's start setting up for February.
March,
March,
yeah. I'm actually slightly afraid by the fact that December only has two objectives.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's read it.
We've been preparing for this contingency. Kurtarus Court is in panic, so I've hired paramilitary assistance to help with the trouble spots. You have to partner with them to keep things under control until more research can be done on Kota. You'll also need to complete two objectives this month. We know you're up to this challenge.
Okay.
And then X first.
43 and 5.
From this point on, whenever you see these circles, open and resolve them. So it doesn't say we resolve them now.
Oh, yes.
Because if you look at February, it said open and resolve.
Oh.
So presumably okay. They're going to be on the next few cards then, because we haven't had a stop
yet. Yeah.
Eradicate at least one disease.
That's interesting, yep.
Have a military base in each six of the six region.
And this is a person.
Operations expert.
Oh, the builder man.
Okay.
And a funded event.
We didn't see those circles.
I'm confused.
Okay, well, wait.
And we can't possibly run across those circles otherwise, so...
Because presumably...
Please someone clarify these things.
One of these has the military bases in.
Yeah.
Well, one of these packages.
Wait, let me see.
Spoiler times again.
Let me just give it a quick check.
There's two of those. That's interesting.
Yeah, there's two of X.
Ah.
I think it's just saying you don't want to get ahead of yourself when you're doing this. Because the other one you could do in parallel, whereas this one you do it.
So that's
and
the,
resolve it
that's,
one at a time.
That's what we were missing before of the yellow sticker saying, oh, by the way, you need to open this package.
Yeah.
Okay, so...
Yeah, package two is a bag of military bases.
And the rules... Military shuttle flight. Ooh, so we can shuttle between military bases.
Yeah, so they're
if
basically
the character
research
has a military
stations.
Symbol.
Ah, yes.
Right.
So only military characters.
Which quarry is, I believe.
She?
Yes. She is.
And operations is also.
Yep.
Yeah.
As an action build, a structure, once per turn, connecting a city. Oh.
He's going to be pretty good, actually, next game, because...
Yes.
Yeah, so did we open 43?
No. We've only done X so far.
Okay, and 43 is what?
Change. LD.
Oh.
Oh.
LD. Oh, it's one of the cards.
Yeah, that's obviously something someone's made.
Yeah, that's
for this version.
Two. Which one is LD?
That is
LD 0710.
Okay, so someone needs to find LD 0710.
I don't even know how I would know what is.
It says on the corner of the cards.
Oh yeah, so the win bonus, for instance, is LD 12. Oh, it's LD. Is it LD 7210? There's three we need to change.
LD change LD 0710. Yeah. LD
0709B. I think it might be the reference cards. LD 07B.
Oh yeah, no. It's the reference card because we add another action.
Oh, yeah.
The military shuttle.
Set state... Did
two.
Say state two?
Yeah, but there's more stuff we changed to state 2 still.
No, it's the reference cards.
There's 4 of them. Well,
yeah,
more of them.
And there's 4
so
LB,
mine is LB07B.
Oh, I see. And mine's LD09.
Yeah.
So, let's see. Which one?
And Lambs is 10.
Yeah.
X. 3, I removed 4, 3. Where's X?
We've done X. X was
5
here. So now we do 5.
Haven't we done 5?
No.
Nope. Exhausted, you
These
may drive...
These are new scars.
Wait, what does that say? You may drive... Oh. Okay. Which one? That was from 5?
Yeah, yeah, these were from 5. Yeah. 3 new scars.
And the last one was X. Okay, I think I deleted all the ones now.
Yeah. Interesting.
New scars go in the scar bag.
Delete
the stickers
that one.
We've uncovered.
We now have security clearance.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, so we should have had one of those.
So you
for...
can delete packages 1 and 2.
Yeah, because we opened them.
Yeah. Also, can you flip package 6 so it's actually flat? Damn it.
I don't know how. Wait, I think I can do this.
And then it popped into P.
Congratulations.
There we go.
Almost. No, damn it.
Try that again.
Oh, now it's in 5.
Nope, it doesn't. But I want it to fall over.
Set it flat again.
What?
It's in 5.
It's not the first item in 5 anymore.
Oh dear.
Can you access the second item?
Let me just...
There it is.
Oh.
Yeah, put it there.
Okay. Let's just... We'll have to live with the fact. There we go.
There we go.
Don't
now you
touch
cannot
it.
Not move it. I'll lock it again.
I'll never poke it.
Alright, what's the next thing in the Legacy deck? At the end of your first game in March... Okay.
Yeah, now we have a bag of military bases.
Right, get this one deceased.
So we have to cure and then... No, we have to eradicate one disease and build military bases. That's it.
Yeah, so... but this one must always be one of the objectives. So we actually have 3 objectives.
That doesn't...
No, wait.
Yeah, it does say that.
So do we just have to complete 2 of these?
Apparently, yeah, I think so. I think that's what this means.
So we discover
we complete
the cures
2 of these
to
3, objectives.
And then we either eradicate 1 or build 6 military bases.
Yeah.
Is that how that works?
I mean, that's how I'm interpreting this.
Which, if you look, the regions are marked on the map. North
America,
South America, Europe, Africa, Asia, and Pacific Rim. Pacific Rim's fine. I mean, they've got Jaegers, so they're sorted.
Yeah. I mean, hopefully we don't have to deal with the kaiju, at least.
That would put an unfortunate spin on this game.
Yes.
I mean, it's possible that's what the blue disease is. It's actually kaiju blue.
Yes, that's why it can't be cured, because we don't have Jaegers. I bet Coda's at some point going to mutate into a zombie virus.
Almost certainly.
And that's why we suddenly have military.
Well, there's the spoiler stuff that we read.
Well, that didn't mention zombies.
No.
So yeah, I think we're going to have to think carefully about which objectives we want to go for to pick characters for next time. Certainly if we go for the eradicate one disease option, then you're going to want the medic.
Yeah.
Because they can just walk through a city and auto-clear it.
Yeah.
Whereas if we're going for military bases, we want the ops expert.
Does the ops expert, does that also... Yeah, it says build a structure.
Yep.
So he could build military bases without spending actions.
He can build a structure in the city he's in, and once per turn, discard...
He can discard a card
move from any city containing a structure to any other city, including rioting and collapsed cities, by discarding any card. So, he can just go, I'm going to Ho Chi Minh, discard Atlanta, I'm there.
I look it up, yeah, it's as indicated at the top of the board, that's how many objectives we have to complete that month. So we can complete any combination of these two.
Yeah, but this first one has to be one of them.
Yes. No?
This
must be one of the objectives you complete to win. So we've got to discover the cures to three diseases and one of the other two.
Yeah, and have a military base in each region and eradicate at least one.
So
I think this one is easier than the other, especially with the specialist.
Yes. Yeah.
Although with the medic, it's also easier to eradicate. So.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, we just basically have to decide which one we're going for. Also, put the scientist back in the pile.
Well, I know what I might consider given the stuff we saw at the... If the spoiler stuff, but disregarding that, I know which one I pick. I picked the easier one.
Yeah. Do we get to keep military bases like we do research stations?
I don't think so. We don't have.
That's not an upgrade.
Wait, it might be because this one is drawn before then.
Yeah.
So this might include like pre-installed in military bases.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Because we did get things like more scars just now.
Yeah.
Yeah, and 21 and 22 contain a bunch of things, so...
I was just reading about destroyed research stations. That could go really badly for you. You could end up losing both research stations and have no start for the next game.
Yeah, so then Atlanta.
If there are no research stations, you start in the ruins of Atlanta.
And to be fair, we've actually made, like, spent game upgrades such that we no longer technically need research stations.
Yeah.
Unless some kind of thing comes in later where we can actually start curing Coda again.
With guns.
Cured with guns. Shoot the disease until it's cured.
Yeah, because it's zombies.
But obviously the black disease is zombies.
No, they have... You know these big pharma always competing.
There are two zombie viruses. Oh, yeah. Good.
And CODA's the one that's effective. And one is made by Umbrella, who's just, you know, the most worthless evil bad guys ever.
Yeah, Umbrella is just insanely incompetent.
I don't know. I would argue that... I was going to say Black Mesa, but that's not the right one. Aperture Labs is probably more incompetent.
Maybe.
Why can't I lift Macquarie? Macquarie, not Macquarie. There we go. Alright.
Character selection time.
Pick characters.
Oh, we're going for March already.
Yeah.
I thought we were going to save that for Thursday, as we've hit about 2 hours already.
That is true. It is getting a bit late for me.
Fine.
I mean, I'm quite keen to play, but I just realized it is getting a bit late for some people, so...
Yeah, I should probably go to bed. Also, I'm going to play the quarantine specialist. We still can't do anything about blue, so we need quarantines.
So the question is if we should just actually skip the researcher this time and go for military bases instead?
I mean, we still need to...
Oh, yeah, no, yeah, so... Three. I guess researcher.
Maybe we skip the scientist and we go for... Ops expert and dispatcher.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that means ops expert gets to have a relationship.
Yeah.
But with whom? And what's his name?
That is the question.
He looks like a Brian.
Or more like operations expert.
No.
You already picked a character.
I want to change my character choice.
Well, I guess I can be the operations specialist. Operations expert, rather.
Yeah, so you get to name them and pick their relationship.
Oh, okay, so...
Clearly they're rivals with the... the what's his face dispatcher. I just think that thematically seems appropriate for some reason.
Yeah, but does it, gameplay wise is it a good idea?
It's actually quite good because they discard cards to move to new cities, and then they can discard any city card, and then the dispatcher can go, "Ooh, I'll have that."
Yeah, which will allow you to trade cards at a 2-for-1 rate.
Yes.
And not trade pass, I guess.
The other option is starting the turn. We can look at the top two cards of the player deck.
It's only if you're in the same city, though. Yeah. That's the problem. Whereas the other one is any time.
Or the other is family members. If you start your turn in the same city as a family member, gain one extra action.
So, something I would really like you to check the FAQ on. What happens when someone plays a funded event? Because could you discard two cards to get that card back?
That's playing it. It's not... Or is it discarding it?
Rivals is plays or discards.
Yeah, so yes, you could.
Because it's a card, it's not a city card.
Getting funded events back seems like a pretty good deal. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I mean,
the only other one would be to be rivals with our friend the scientist over here, who has to discard cards to quarantines. Not to quarantines, to epidemics.
Yeah, but the scientist is not in... I guess we can
be in this one. It would be in future
ones. I guess we can pre-plan. But do we want the scientist in the future ones? That's like the big question. Will we use this character again?
Yeah.
And we don't know. I mean, curing diseases will always be important. So.
Particularly as we start getting more upgrades, because once we hit...
Yeah, so I would say putting a relationship on the scientist, not a bad idea then. But that means the operations expert and the scientist both have to be in play.
Yeah. I was going to say, the scientist gets super useful once we get to easier agents, because then they only need three cards to discover a cure.
Yeah. This but that's not going to happen for a while.
No.
That might happen next month. Who knows?
Who knows? If we have to redo March, that might be a thing.
I mean, we only have two funding now.
Yeah.
We will probably have to redo March.
I mean, we did only use two funded events in that last one.
Yeah, but funded events also thickens up the deck.
Yeah, it gives you more time between epidemics.
Yeah, no, I've just found someone else asking about this, and yeah, totally legal to use rifles to recycle funded events that way. That said, of course, if you keep winning, you lose all your funded events, so it's a limited total capacity.
Just
squab but even one so, month. Pick up city cards again as a way of extra city card trading is kind of handy. So
yeah, I'm thinking Salty Bob will be a rival with someone.
He's Salty Bob, is he?
Yeah, he is Salty Bob.
Salty Bob the Builder.
Yeah, Bob the Builder got older and pissed at things.
Because he can't fix it.
Yeah, he can't. He can't fix this man.
So he broken. Who is the rival with?
That is the question. I mean, the dispatcher might be good.
Like, I'm definitely thinking scientist because I think the one we'll probably face out next is probably the researcher. Though the researcher does have forecaster and stuff now, so
yeah, the researcher is super handy.
Yeah,
it's basically because I actually really want that on the scientist.
Oh, okay. Overlooked rule: your hand limit applies immediately after getting a card from another player.
Yeah, I think that's one of the slight differences on Legacy compared to the original Pandemic, where it didn't apply until your turn again. I mean, we don't have to do a relationship, do we? It's just if we don't.
No,
It
says give.
Oh, it's
only yeah, it's only choice.
When creating a character, give them a relationship.
Okay. So yeah, rivals with, pick the rival.
Well, who's going to be discarding a bunch of cards? That is the question.
I'm just going to say the dispatcher.
Although yeah. Well, the dispatcher no longer is because they've got pilot.
Oh, yeah. So they would just be picking cards up.
When taking a direct flight.
Which is when you discard a card too, isn't it?
Yeah, direct flight is discard to move to the city named on the card.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the charter flight is the one that would then not be would be what you use to get rid of a card. So I mean, Keeb as a pilot could fly somewhere, revealing the card, and then charter a flight from that place to get anywhere else.
Yeah.
And that's the only way I could see consuming cards. That or building things.
Maybe it is better for the researcher then. Even though we don't get the bonus this game.
I mean, the research,
Throw it on the scientist, you mean, yeah.
Throw it on the scientist, yes, sorry. Because we know if they're in play, they've got to discard cards every epidemic now.
Yeah.
Rival... Salty Bob.
Mm.
Wait,
do you have and, to resize this? And my move this? A pawn to any city with another pawn doesn't actually count as the direct flight.
No, it's a different action, isn't it?
It's just an action of just move a pawn.
Yeah.
So it's not a direct flight or a charter flight, so... And we're not driving or ferrying either, so... Yeah. That is always a valid way of getting people into ruined cities, so... Yeah, that's interesting.
Hmm. In another interesting way to use rivals, if you've got two people with nearly full hands, the event card that lets you put down two quarantine markers.
Oh, yes.
Just put down all 12 on all the possible cities.
Yeah, just keep spamming it. Oh, you're going to discard it? You're going to play that? I will discard two to fill my hat, get that back, and... Just keep bouncing it. Oh man, being able to do that for Brazilian population.
Yeah, the downside of that though is it's removed from the deck. It's so the card can keep coming up. Not the card can keep coming up. It reduces the number of cities that can come up.
Yes.
So they're much more likely to get things.
Also for discarding due to hand limit as well. If you have to discard for hand limit, then your rival can discard two to grab whatever you've got to discard if that's you end up having to discard something useful. Or you deliberately go up to hand limit to make and then discard the thing that they need to cure a disease or something like that. It's a very interesting mechanic. There's definitely some fun aspects to this.
Yep. We gotta get it even more. So we're still only in month 3.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. December is still a ways off.
They're just gonna keep piling things on us. We have another 6 boxes.
And a bunch of more packets of things.
Well, 5 boxes, because we hope to never open 8.
Yep. Although I do kind of want to know what's in there.
Well, when we finish the game, we'll open it if we don't open it through losing. I imagine it's just something like... It just simplifies the game a lot.
Yeah. I am super tempted to get the physical copy of this because... got a few friends at work and they do a semi-regular board gaming night.
Mm.
And so we could actually play this once a month for a year and get tons of value out of it. The problem is there's 5 of us, not 4, so...
That is awkward.
There's ways to play the original with 5, but I don't know how...
I think the way we'd do it is with 5. We'd probably just have one person play, 2 people play as a team.
Yeah. I mean, some people have said they usually... The way they do 5 players, just play as a hive mind.
Yeah. I was just going to say, because if my internet connection didn't come back,
particularly bad